Hi, I'm Tracy Chernault. Welcome to another one of the battlefields here in the Petersburg campaign of the American Civil War. We're on the Hatcher's Run battlefield today. This fighting takes place on February 5th, 6th, and 7th of 1865. This will be another attempt by Union forces to try and break the remaining supply lines the Confederates are using to keep Petersburg and the capital of Richmond under Confederate control. It will be here on February 5th that General Grant is going to send a division of cavalry, as well as the Union 5th Corps, to try and break the Confederate supply lines that are just off to the west of us. The Boyden Plank Road was an important wagon road being used to bring supplies from the broken Weldon Railroad to the south of us into Petersburg. On February 5th, the Union cavalry will manage to capture a dozen or so wagons full of Confederate supplies, but that being all they find, they pull back to this area to go into camp on the night of February 5th, along with the Union 5th Corps right in this area. At the same time, the Union 2nd Corps has been engaged just to the north of us along Hatcher's Run at what was called the fighting along Armstrong's Mill. General Robert E. Lee is in church on Sunday, February 5th, when he hears of this fighting, and so he will leave the service and come here to try and organize the defenses to protect his supply lines. On the morning of February 6th, on Monday, Confederates will have come to this area with two divisions of infantry under John Pegram and Clement Evan, and it will be here in this area that they will decide to defend the supply lines coming into Petersburg. The Union 5th Corps is going to attack right along where we're standing now, and it will be in this area that the highest ranking casualty will occur. General John Pegram of the Confederate forces will fall here. A tragic story for the Confederates. He had been married just 3 weeks earlier in one of the most highly publicized weddings to take place in the war. He had married the belle of the Confederacy in Hetty Cary. She had moved here to Petersburg to be closer to her husband. And that afternoon, when his body is taken back to her, it is said that she had been a fiance for 3 years, a bride for 3 weeks, and now she was a widow. The Confederate forces here on the night of February 6th are going to hold and protect the supply line. Grant is going to send reinforcements to the force that's here. He will end up with 30,000 soldiers in this area, while the Confederates will end up with just a little more than 13,000 men to defend Petersburg. The fighting on the 6th is going to be the heaviest of the fighting. On the morning of the 7th, the overnight, there has been a winter storm move into the area. And so you have, on the morning of February 7th, the trees coated with ice hanging over. It was a partially wooded area, much as it is today. The number of pine and oak forests dotting the agricultural landscape. And because of the nature of the weather, and because of the coldness of this campaign, many of the Union soldiers, when they left camp, didn't bring tents. They only marched out with what they had, their weapons and supplies. And so they're freezing to death in the field. Many of the wounded are remarked to have actually frozen to death because of the extreme conditions when this storm moves in. And because of that, the fighting ends on February 7th with only the gaining of some ground here to the south of Petersburg by Union forces. Over 1,500 casualties will be suffered by them in this campaign. And then the Confederates, who have suffered about 1,000 casualties, will still retain the two supply lines coming into Petersburg. However, they're going to be forced with having to stretch out their lines even further here to the south of town, thus making it even harder to put men in the trenches around Petersburg because of the now distance that they're going to have to cover. Another one of the campaigns at Petersburg that's going to end in almost a stalemate, but is going to end or begin the end of the campaign in just a couple more months as the fighting resumes here later in the spring.